Welcome back to the beautiful Anna Maria Island. In last week's video, we took you on a tour of Anna Maria's amazing beaches. But in this week's video, we're finally leaving the beach to show you the best of everything else that Anna Maria has to offer. So if you're just here to see the beautiful Anna Maria beaches, you can go ahead and click on the link above now. But if you're interested in seeing the rest of what this great island has to offer, then you've come to the right place. And what a better way to start off your day on the island than with some seriously delicious donuts. Located at 210 Pine Avenue, the Donut Experiment provides customers with the experience of creating their own donuts. Here, customers can top their freshly fried donuts with their own selection of icing, toppings, and drizzle. Once you've grabbed your donuts and freshly brewed coffee, you can take them to go or enjoy both out on the front patio. On our visit, we created one of our own donuts and also chose two of the rotating specials, which included a key lime and sriracha donut. And while we both thought the sriracha donut sounded a bit strange, we agreed that it was excellent.
So it's really peanut buttery, a little spicy, and not very sweet at all. So not at all what I was expecting, but still really good.
But it was no surprise that Skylar's favorite donut was the key lime pie. And mine was my own personal raspberry fruity pebble creation.
It's delicious.
Next up on the list takes us less than half a mile to the northeast. Here, visitors will find the Anna Maria City Pier. The historic pier is the city's longest, extending 700 feet out into the Gulf waters. At the end of the pier, visitors will find the City Pier Grill and Bait Shop, which offers daily breakfast, lunch, and dessert, plus an assortment of beers and a daily happy hour. The City Pier regularly showcases talented local musicians like Paul Fournier, and also offers a great spot to enjoy the Gulf views along with a local brew. If you've enjoyed this video so far, or are interested in other Florida travel content, don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications on. The third top thing to do on Anna Maria Island takes us about 5 miles south to Bradenton Beach. Located just a quick walk or scooter ride from the popular Bridge Street, you'll find the Wicked Cantina at 101 7th Street North. Open from 7:30 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily, the cantina serves up fresh, Austin-style Tex-Mex food for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Despite offering high-quality food right across the street from the beach, the daily happy hour and unlimited chips and salsa make this place a real bargain. And if you're feeling worn out from an exhausting day at the beach, the $1.25 beers may just be the perfect way to turn your day around. And if you're not a big fan of cheap beer, the mango margaritas are delicious and refreshing as well. And the food? We'll just let the video do the speaking for itself. Now that we've re-energized with some great food and drinks, it's time for number 4 on the list, Explore Bridge Street. Located where a wooden bridge used to provide the only means of access to the entire island, historic Bridge Street offers visitors an assortment of great spots to shop, relax, eat, drink, and have a good time. One of our favorite Bridge Street spots is a relatively new arrival to the Courtyard stores. Here at 119 Bridge Street, you'll find Tinto's, a Colombian coffee shop, bakery, and deli.
So I got an iced latte. It's sweetened with sugar cane, and it's made with dark Colombian.
It's
sounds refreshing on a hot day like today.
How's your coffee?
Well, I'm already kind of regretting ordering a hot cafe con leche on a 90 degree day, but it is really good, so I'm still gonna drink it.
If you're looking to enjoy a seafood dinner while on Bridge Street, look no further than the Blue Marlin, which serves fresh fish brought in from a local Cortez fishing fleet. And if it's shopping you're looking for, Bridge Street provides several great options, including Bridge Street Interiors, a great spot to add to your jewelry collection. And just a few doors down, you'll find the Back Alley Cafe, a shop that appeals to even those who hate shopping. Here you can shop for art and homemade gifts, while those non-shopping enthusiasts can enjoy a coffee, wine, or craft beer. And if you're into shopping and drinking at the same time, well, you can even do that too. After having a real good time on Bridge Street, driving to your next destination may not be a wise option. But don't worry, number 5 on this list has you covered. So let's take a ride on the Monkey Bus. One step into the Monkey Bus is all you'll need to realize that this isn't your typical ride-hailing service. The bus has no scheduled stops, but offers door-to-door service across the entire island with just a phone call. The Monkey Bus runs 7 days a week from noon to 3 a.m. and seats up to 16 people. And there's no official charge to ride the Monkey Bus, as it operates off of tips only. Just make sure you have some cash before you hop on. Generally speaking, a trip to the doctor's office is something that most prefer to avoid, but on Anna Maria Island, it might just be the exact place you want to be. At number 6 on our list, the doctor's office can be found in downtown Holmes Beach, at the former location of, you guessed it, a real doctor's office. Once seated at the craft cocktail bar, visitors are immediately provided with a complimentary wellness shot, which will, without a doubt, cure whatever ails you. Assuming you can still pass the sobriety exam, we'd recommend ordering one of the 10 handcrafted cocktails, especially the Kiss Kiss Bang Bang. And if you're not in a cocktail mood, the doctor's office offers a variety of beers and wine as well, ensuring that this will be the best trip to the doctor's office you've ever had. Next up on the list of top things to do on Anna Maria Island is to catch some live music. And whether you're on the city pier, Bridge Street, or in between, a talented local musician is likely performing nearby. One of our favorite spots on the island to catch a band is the Freckled Fin. Here, if your timing is right, you might be able to catch a performance from Anna Maria native Trevor Bystrom and his band. Another great spot to catch Trevor and other local bands is the Blue Marlin, which hosts live musicians every Friday and Saturday night. And that leads us to our 8th and final thing to do on Anna Maria Island, and that is to catch a sunset. And one of the best spots to do just that is at the Manatee Public Beach. A favorite spot of locals and vacationers alike, the Manatee Public Beach offers a wide range of amenities, including restrooms, changing stations, lifeguards, and one of our personal favorites, a tiki bar. But on most evenings, the top feature of them all is without a doubt the sunset. And we can't think of a better way to cap off an evening on the island. But if you're interested in seeing much more of Anna Maria's top beaches, you'll want to check out our Anna Maria Ultimate Beach Guide. And you can do just that by clicking on this video now. Thanks for watching.